Hi, this week's lesson is on the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 19 through 51. We start off here where John the Baptist comes on the scene, and the Pharisees and temple assistants send out people and ask, "Who are you? Are you the Messiah? Are you Elijah? Are you a prophet?" And he denies all three of those. And they said, "Well, you have to tell us something. Tell us who you are." And he says, he quotes Isaiah saying, "I'm the voice calling out in the wilderness, prepare a straight pathway for the Lord." So he was part of God's plan, and his purpose was to proclaim that the Messiah was coming, to repent from your sin and turn to God, turn to the things of God. That's what his baptism was under. So we pick up here in verse about 24. So again, the Pharisees asking, "If you aren't the Messiah or Elijah or prophet, what right do you have to baptize?" He said, "I baptize with water, but one is coming soon that baptizes with the Holy Spirit, and I am not fit to be his slave." And then the next day we see that Jesus comes towards him, and he says, "Behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world." And it goes on to say that he didn't know him. He didn't know he was the one. He certainly knew him as a kinsman, as a maybe a second cousin. Mary was the cousin of Elizabeth, his mother, and so we know that they likely knew each other. But he didn't know that Jesus was the coming Messiah until later on. We find that the Holy Spirit descended upon him as if a dove and remained upon him, and this was a sign that God sent to John, saying that this was going to take place. So as we read on, again we see the Holy Spirit descending on him like a dove. "I didn't know he was the one, but God sent me to baptize with water and told me, when you see the Holy Spirit descending and resting upon someone, he is the one you are looking for. I saw this happen to Jesus," he says, so he calls him out by name. "I testify that he is the Son of God," verse 34. Later the next day, and this is a 4-day process through these verses here. The following day, John was standing there with two of his disciples, and he said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." And immediately those disciples went and followed him. One of those was Andrew, and Andrew went to his brother, which happened to be Simon Peter, and he said to him, "We have found the Messiah." And Simon Peter, so Andrew took Simon Peter to Jesus. And then the next day, Jesus comes up on Philip, and Philip says, Jesus says to Philip, "Come be my disciple." And then Philip went ahead and looking for Nathaniel, I guess was a friend of his, and he says, in the present tense of this word, he says, "We have found the very person Moses and the prophets wrote about. His name is Jesus, the son of Joseph of Nazareth." And what he's saying here is, in the tense that he uses here, he says, "We have found the Messiah." There's no doubt here, and there's no need to look any further. And his name is Jesus. That's, if you amplified those verses, what they're saying, that's what it's saying there. And then, so Nathaniel kind of mocks here. He says, "Nazareth, what good could come out of Nazareth?" And then he comes to meet Jesus, and Jesus says, "Oh, behold, a righteous man. Here comes an honest man, a true son of Israel, one without deceit," he says. And Nathaniel says, "How do you even know me?" And he said, "I saw you underneath the fig tree." And at that point, Nathaniel responds, "You are the Son of God, the King of Israel." And Jesus says, "Just because I told you I saw you under a fig tree, you're going to believe that I am the Son of God, the King of Israel? That's where you're going to say these things?" And he says, I assure you that you will see far more greater things than this. You will see the angels of heaven ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." So here in this is a quick version of these series of verses, but we see the Lamb of God, and the Lamb of God is an identity of Christ, and the Lamb was important in the Passover, where a lamb without blemish was slaughtered, and the blood was taken and placed across the doorpost, across the top, and along the sides. And the angel of death, or the destroyer, God allowed to take the firstborn children of the people of Egypt because they were seeking other gods, even thinking that Pharaoh was God. But the Israelites worshiped the one true God, Yahweh. And so the angel of death that passed overnight passed over those Hebrew homes that had been obedient to the Lord at that time. And also we see the word Messiah come out here, which is the Christ, the anointed one. And Jesus was proclaimed to be that. And we have been given a promise of a Messiah throughout the whole Old Testament. And God met this when Jesus came incarnate to earth. And that leads us into our final term here, that Jesus describes himself as the Son of Man. He was fully man. He was fully human. But he was also fully God. So God came to earth to take away our sin, my sin and your sin. And I hope you acknowledge this, not only in your mind. You may know the Sunday school answer or the church answer, but I pray that you acknowledge this in your heart as well. That you truly received the free gift of grace, because you were saved by grace through faith, not of yourselves, not of good works or anything we can do. It is a gift from God, so that no man can boast. We can't have a checklist of things to do, but it was because of God. If we receive that, Jesus says you're born again, you're made right with God, you become a child of God at that point, and your sins are forgiven, and you're welcomed into heaven. So I pray that you've done this today, and thank you for this time we can share together.